Good day, students. Welcome to the mathematics class. So today we start the new chapter, surface areas and volumes. So surface area means the area of the faces of the given solid. So like, let us see here. So here these are the solids. So the area of the faces of the given solid, that one is called as the what? Surface areas. And volume means the space occupied by these solids is called as the volume of that solid. So surface area means the area of the faces of the, so the given solid, and the volume means the space occupied by this figure or this solid is called as the volume of that solid. Means how much space this figure will occupy, that will be the volume of that solid. So now let us recall the formula first. So first of all, about cube and cuboid. Cube and cuboid. So, what is the surface area of cube and cuboid? You will get two types of area, surface area, that is lateral surface area and total surface area. So, what is the lateral surface area of cube? Lateral surface area, LSA. Lateral surface area of cube. So which is equal to 4a². That means lateral means area of only four sides of cube. That means except the top and bottom faces. So you will get only four sides at the side. So lateral surface area means the area of four faces except the top and bottom. So you will get six faces for the cube. So except top and bottom, four faces. So area of one face is a². That means area of four faces is how much? 4a². So the lateral surface area of cube is 4a², where a means side of the cube. And next, total surface area of cube. So total surface area means, so total faces how many you will get? 6. So area of one face is a². Then total surface area of cube is 6 faces, 6a². That is 6a². Next, third one, a lateral surface area of cuboid. So lateral surface area of cuboid. So like cube also, cuboid means except the area of top and bottom faces, only the side four faces area, that will give the lateral surface area of cuboid. So that one you will get 2h into bracket L plus B. Because what is the area of the side face? Here it is length, and this is breadth, and this is height. Then front face, what is the area of front face? This is in the shape of rectangle, that is L into H means L into H. And next one, back face is also same, because opposite faces of a cuboid will be same in area. So that means you will get the back face also L into H, LH. So this is what front and back faces area. And next side face. What are they? H and P. This is also rectangle shape. So what is the area? Length into breadth. Here length is B and breadth is H. That means B into H. It will give the area of this face. So BH you will get. So opposite face also same only. B into H. B. So lateral surface area means the area of the four sides of a cuboid. So that means add these all four areas. So LB, sorry LH plus LH. 2LH you will get. Plus BH plus BH. How many BH are there? 2BH. In these two common is 2, 2 and next HH. So 2H into bracket what will remain here? L plus B. So the lateral surface area of cuboid is 2H into bracket L plus B. And next total surface area of cuboid. So total surface area means area of all six faces. Already four area of four faces you got, that is 2LH and 2BH. And what about now? Here it is, remaining two faces, top and bottom. So what is the area of bottom face? So here it is, length and breadth is there. That is LB, rectangle shape. Therefore area will be L into B. L. And opposite face also same. Top and bottom will be opposite. So area of opposite faces will be same. So that one also you will get that one as L into B. Means LB. So LB plus LB. So total how much you will get? 2L. So now in these three what is the common? 2. What you will get? LB plus BL plus HL. So this is the total surface area of cuboid. That is 2 into bracket LB plus BH plus HL. So 2 into bracket LB plus BH plus HL. So this is the total surface area of cuboid. Next, our volume of the cuboid cuboid. So volume of cube. So what is the formula? Side into side into side. That means if side is A, A into A into A. Means what do we get? A cube. So volume of cube is A cube. And next, what about the volume of cuboid? Already you know that. Length into breadth into height. So volume of cuboid, which is equals to length into breadth into height. So these are the six formulae about cuboid, cuboid. So that is lateral surface area, total surface area and volume of cuboid, cuboid. Next, cylinder. So for cylinder you will get curved surface area and total surface area. So what is this? Curved surface area. Upper cylinder. So curved surface area of upper cylinder. So what you will get? So curved surface area means only the this one curved area except the top and the bottom. So if you cut this cylinder you will get a what? You will get a rectangle shape. Means if you cut the cylinder, if you cut this cylinder through height, this is the height of the cylinder, through height and open that, you will get the or rectangle shape. That means this is same length and only height, because we cut the cylinder about the height. So if you open this, it will become height. Then what? This will length will become. So if you again close that, that will become circular shape upside and the downside. That means it will become what? Circumference of the circle means 2 pi r. What is the circumference of the circle? 2 pi r. Then, now this is a rectangle shape. You know that area formula for the rectangle. Length into breadth. Length how much is there? 2 pi r. Into breadth is h. So you will get that one as 2 pi r h. So, the curved surface area of a cylinder is 2 pi r h. And next one. Total surface area. Total surface area of a cylinder. So which is equal to? So this is the curved surface area. Total surface area means curved surface area plus these are the circular shape means area of two circles. So 2 pi r h plus curved surface area plus area of two circles. So two circles, area of one circle is pi r square. So what do you get here common? 2 pi r common. So take that outside. 2 pi r into bracket h plus r, r, r plus h. So the total surface area of cylinder is 2 pi r into bracket r plus h or h plus r. So this is the whole CS and TS of cylinder. And next, volume of cylinder. Volume of cylinder. So for finding the volume of cylinder, just we need height and area of base. So base, it will be circular shape. So area of circle is pi r square and height is h. Then multiply both, what you will get? Pi r square h. So the volume of cylinder is pi r square h. So these are the three formulae about what? Cylinder. And next, core. So for core also you get a CSA, TSA and volume. So curved surface area. Curved surface area of a core, which is equal to formula A, pi r l. Pi r l, curved surface, except the base, only the curve. So, what is the formula? Pi r l. So, here, l means slant height. So, this is the height, and this is radius. And this cross line segment is called as your slant height. And that one how you will get slant height. So where L is equals to square root of R square plus H square. So slant height. How we need to find slant height? Square root of R square plus H square. Because this is a right angle triangle. If you use the Pythagoras theorem, you will get L is equals to square root of R square plus H square. So this is the curved surface area of a cone. And next, total surface area. Total surface area of a cone. So which is equal to? So curved surface area plus base area. Curved surface area plus base area will give the total surface area. and base is which shape is a circular. So that means area of circle is pi r square. So in these two common is pi r. So take that outside. Pi r into bracket l plus r or r plus l. So the total surface area of cone is pi r into bracket r plus l. And next, volume of cone, which is equal to 1/3 the volume of cylinder. If cylinder and cone are of same radius and same height, then volume of cone will be the 1/3 the volume of cylinder. That means already you know that volume of cylinder, what is that? Pi r square h. Then 1/3 means 1/3 pi r square h. Volume of cylinder cone will be 1/3 the volume of cylinder. So these are the three formulae about cone, that is CSA, TSA and volume of cone. And next, sphere and hemisphere. So here now, for sphere only one area will get, that is total surface area. You don't get the curved or total like that. Only will get total surface area or simply surface area of sphere. Total surface area of a sphere which is equal to, so just this is a sphere, find the radius of this and draw four circles and cover this sphere by those four circles, those will cover this sphere exactly. That means total surface area of sphere is area of four circles of this radius, means 4 pi r square total surface area of a sphere, 4 pi r square. And next, for hemisphere means half of this sphere. For hemisphere again you will get two types of areas, that is one is curved surface area and another one is total surface area. So curved surface area means it is half of this sphere, that means curved surface area will be the half of the total surface area of sphere, means how much you will get, half of this means 2 pi r square. So curved surface area of hemisphere will be 2 pi r square and total surface area will be curved surface area plus this base, it is also circular shape. What is the area of circle? Pi r square. So 2 pi r square plus pi r square, 3 pi r square. So here you will get again two types, that is curved surface area of hemisphere. Hemi means half. So hemisphere h is equal to 2 pi r square and total surface area of hemisphere h is equal to 3 pi r square. So curved surface area of hemisphere is 2 pi r square and total surface area of hemisphere is 3 pi r square. Because for total surface area you should add CSA and base of this hemisphere. Base of the hemisphere will be circular shape. So that is also area of pi r square. Means circle means pi r square. So 2 pi r square plus pi r square, you will get 3 pi r square. So next come. Volume of sphere. So which is equal to? Formula is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. And next, 17th formula, volume of hemisphere. So volume of hemisphere, that means half the volume of the sphere. That means you will get 2 by 3 pi r cube. 2 by 3 pi r cube. So these are the 17 formulae about the solids, cube, cuboid, cylinder, cone, sphere and hemisphere. So by using these formulae only, we are going to solve the given examples. And in this chapter, here you will study about the combination of the solids. Like, if you keep this hemisphere on the cone, you will get another shape. That is, it is a combination of hemisphere and a cone. And if you keep this hemisphere on this, you will get another shape. And if you keep this cone on the cylinder, you will get another shape. So, here we will study that area of surface area of combinations of the solids. In the previous standard, in the 9th standard, we have studied that surface area of separate solids. But here, now, we will study about the surface area of combinations of solids. So, we will see some examples now.